All right. Welcome, guys. This is actually going to be our first playthrough that we do for Star Wars Journeyer. With this playthrough for Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic, what we want to do is, for research purposes, of course, go back and double check our storylines and see how well our story is continuous with this storyline. What we want to do, because this is the story of Darth Revan, we want to make sure that it's still compatible with what we are, or our story is still compatible with what we are, creating in line with the Darth Revan story. This game was made back in 2003, so keep that in mind if you're new to this game, you don't know what it's about. It's very old, but it is rated one of the best Star Wars games ever made. So there is something to be said about it. It has an amazing story, some amazing RPG gameplay, and I'm going to try not to spoil anything. And because if you're watching this for the first time, you're watching this game for the first time, I don't want to ruin the storyline for you in case you decide to watch one episode and want to buy the game for yourself. But the game is actually $10 on Steam, so it's really cheap, and it's still a great game to play. I am recording this in 1920 by 1080. The actual game, I believe the biggest dimensions that they have is 1260 by 1080 or 966 or something like that. Something ridiculous. It's basically like a 4:3 kind of aspect ratio. Like it's very old. It definitely shows its age. And so what I had to do was use a specific plugin to allow me to showcase this in 1080. So without further ado, let me just see here. We are going to start a new game. So, it's basic character generation. So we get to choose who we want to be. We could be a scoundrel, a scout, or a soldier, or we can be male or female. So, let's see here. So, a scoundrel, a skillful rogue that gets by on stealth and guile. An explorer most at home on the fringes of space, and a battle-ready fighter with no equal in combat. Depend. So do we like want to be like super strong in combat? Probably do, right? Or do we want to do like stealth stuff? I think we just want to, or we could be more like support style character. I don't know. At the end of the day, I think we wanted to be like really strong in combat, because I feel like this is gonna be one of those games. Well, it is one of those games where there's a lot of action, a lot of combat, and we need to be able to do a lot of damage. So let's go ahead. Well, you know what? Let's go ahead and just do a scoundrel. Let's do that one. We're gonna do a custom character portrait. So we get the game does have a few faces that we can choose from. We got like this Fu Manchu thing going on. This guy's a scar. We could do, let's go back. We're going to do like this. Like, this is like a really young Denzel Washington. That's it. His name is going to be Denzel Washington. So now we get to add points into strength, dexterity, constitution, intelligence, wisdom, and charisma. This part of the game basically tells us how well our stats are in a specific area. So if you have constitution, as it says, it adds modifiers to the vitality points gained at each level. It's important for everyone, but essential for soldiers and guardians. Dexterity basically makes you more difficult to hit the higher rating you have. Strength measures physical power. A high strength adds modifiers to melee damage and chance to hit, which is important for characters that use close combat weapons like vibroblades and lightsabers. Intelligence represents knowledge and reasoning. A high intelligence adds modifiers to the number of points a character has to spend on essential skills. Wisdom represents willpower and perception. A high wisdom adds modifiers to Jedi Force points and Force power saving throws. The Force powers of a Jedi with high wisdom are also much harder to resist. And charisma represents personality and the ability to lead. A high charisma adds modifiers to Force-related feats and powers that are very important to all Jedi classes. It is also central to any persuasive talker. So let's see what the recommended is for Scoundrel. So it recommends putting 14 into Charisma, 16 into Dexterity, 10 into Constitution, 14 Intelligence, 12 Wisdom, and 10 in Strength. So basically, the Scoundrel relies on being able to dodge, be agile. So we might, I mean, we could potentially just put these wherever we want, right? What we might do here actually is remove one from dexterity, and put a point into strength and a point into constitution. We might make it a little bit more even. So like if we took one away from intelligence, leave one in charisma, and go back and strength and constitution. Oh, never mind. A high intelligence adds modifiers to the number of points a character has to spend on skills. We might just do that. Let's do 14. Okay. Skills. So we have 24 remaining points. Let's see what the recommended is. They recommend not going any in persuade. That's a bad idea. I'm going to do persuade up to 4. Let's do treat injury. We'll also do, we have a stealth and awareness. We'll do 2 stealths. One for computer use. One for repair, security. We'll do that. So we'll basically max out persuade and even out the rest. Feats. Okay, some feats allow you to use special items like heavy armor or implants. Other feats modify saving throws and skill checks during the game. And obviously some feats are used during combat. Check the description for details on a specific feat. So as a Scoundrel, we are granted these specific feats to start off the game with. So this is Sneak Attack and Scoundrel's Luck are Scoundrel specific. If we want to, we can actually go through and read. So like Sneak Attack adds extra damage, like if you attack them a specific way if they're stunned or you attack them from behind. And then Scoundrel's Luck adds +2 to our defense, and it's always active. So when it comes to the game, I think we might, I feel like, well, let's let's upgrade our melee weapons here, I think. Possibly. Or we could just... like, add a point into the plus one, so persuade, awareness, and treat injury. We could do that. I think let's do that. Empathy. Then our name. You already know what it's going to be. Denzel Washington. Just look like a young Denzel. Play. All right. I hope you guys are ready for this. I'm excited. Excited to start this series. Oh, these graphics are like, he's like a polygon. Oh, it's so amazing. This game really takes me back to my childhood.
We've been ambushed by a Sith battle fleet. The Endar Spire is under attack. Hurry up, we don't have much time.
Who were you? The Endar Spire?
Did you fall out of your bunk and hit your head?
Sure did.
The Endar Spire is the ship we're stationed on. This ship. You probably don't even know who I am, do you? I'm Trask Olgo, ensign with the Republic Fleet. I'm your bunkmate here on the Endar Spire. We work opposite shifts. I guess that's why you haven't seen me before. Now hurry up! We have to find Bastila.
Who are you?
We have to make sure she makes it off the ship alive.
Who's Bastila?
Bastila is the commanding officer on the Endar Spire. Well, not an officer, really. But she's the one in charge of this mission. One of our primary duties is to guarantee her survival in the event of an enemy attack.
Right.
You swore an oath just like everyone else on this mission. Now it's time to make good on that oath. I know all about your reputation. How you used to smuggle spice and blasters along the Corellian run. I guess the Republic figured since they couldn't catch you, they might as well hire you. And I'll admit, the Republic is in desperate need of someone with your kind of skills. Desperate enough to overlook your shady past. But now that you've signed on for this mission, you're part of the Republic fleet. And Bastila needs all troops at her side during this attack.
Hey, first of all, let's not talk about my shitty past, okay? We've all got one. You know what I'm saying? Oath or no oath, I'm heading to the escape pods. All right, let's go help Bastila.
Hurry up and grab your gear. You need to suit up so we can get out of here.
Okay. Okay. Journal entry added. So this is our room. We've been living on this ship for a little bit. This bed looks very comfortable. I get one sheet and one super flat pillow. It seems like everyone gets a flat pillow.
You can move the mouse to the edges of the screen to rotate the camera. Alternately, moving the mouse while holding down the right mouse button will rotate the camera as well.
You know what? How do you know so much about mice?
Move towards the footlocker, hold down the right mouse button, and face the camera towards it. Then hold down the left mouse button as well to cause the character to run forward.
You know what?
Left-click on an object to select it. Once the footlocker is selected, left-click on...
You know what? You are so helpful. Can you repeat that? we don't want him to repeat it. That's fine. All right. Footlocker, left-click. So we get a stealth field generator, computer spike, security spike, blaster pistol, short sword, clothing, and med pack. We got two med packs, actually. So now, what we have up here on our right, upper corner of the screen, we have... And click these buttons, and we can now equip our stuff. So we're gonna add some clothing. They really don't. These are simple garments that protect a little more than the modesty of the wearer. So we want to be modest. Could put on my stealth field generator, and put on a short sword because we want to chop people's arms off. And so now I'm looking spiffy. I got my sword. Very realistic.
Okay, let's move out.
We should stick together. You'll have more success with the party than on your own. What if I just don't want you?
Because of the attack, this room is in lockdown. But don't worry, I've got the override codes. You'll have to use me to unlock the door.
Okay. So the interesting thing about this game is... Because I ported it, or not ported it, but I just did a plug-in to Denzel Washington is in the game.
Now that the door is open, you better take the lead again.
Because I had to convert this to specifically like 1080p or 1920 by 1080. It kind of like screws up the bars sometimes. So that's a little bit unfortunate, but for the most part, I'm just glad I get to play it.
The threatening to overrun our position. We can't hold out long against their firepower. All hands to the bridge.
That was Karth contacting us on our portable communicators. He's one of the Republic's best pilots. He's seen more combat than the rest of the Endar Spire's crew put together. If he says things are bad, you better believe it. We have to get to the bridge to help defend Bastila. There's a map of the Endar Spire and a copy of Karth's message in your electronic journal, just in case we get separated.
Let's move out. Utility droid. Beep, beep, boop, boop.
That door's locked, and I don't have the code.
See
to
these
open.
Black bars? How they're slowly moving down.
Skill on it if we want to get past.
And then moves all the way down. All right, so we're gonna walk up. Security. Security.
Got it.
Security. Hey. You're standing out in the open.
These Sith must be the advanced boarding party for the Republic.
All right, so we have critical strike and regular attack, and we have a poison grenade. So let's just go attack. So your chances of hitting a target are controlled by your statistics and behind-the-scenes combat rolls. Combat is not affected by your aim, your character's movements, or the movements of your target. So let's attack. Tink. You know what, Trask? You're taking all the fun out of him. Check his remains. We got 27 credits. That droid is dead. Hey, select that guy. We're gonna attack him. Missed! I was totally aiming for him. Yeah, kick him. Where are you running to? Where are you running, boy? All right. Actually can't move. What the heck? Hello? Hold on. I can't move at all. Let me do, let me see. Is it gameplay? Mouse settings? No. Key mapping. So, like, that's my W. So let's go default. Maybe, like, resetting it will help? No? So I can move A and D. I can't move back and forth though. I can click. Okay, I can at least use him. So if I do that, can I go back to my character now? No, he's like permanently stuck. I'm just gonna use Trask. Hopefully he doesn't lock up. Metal box. Will my character follow me? Sure will. It's like stuck. Dude, he just like got some home time. Oh, I still can't move, man. Not very good. Oh wait, hold up. What is this? What is that? Oh, it's stealth mode?
Sure.
Let's just go ahead and move on. Go forward, Denzel. Power shot. Power shot. My guy's about to die, actually. Denzel, you're about to die.
Yes.
Okay, now I can use them. That was weird. I do need a med pack though. Nice. Wait, now I can't move. Oh wait, there we go. What's going on here? It's like freaking out.
It's a dark Jedi. This fight is too much for us. We gotta stay back. All we do is get in the way.
He's got shiny robes.
That was one of the Jedi accompanying Bastila. Damn, they could have used her help.
Unbelievable. She is terrible. All right, let's go get some attacking here. Hey, I do like no damage. I think I have a better weapon, right? Oh, I sure do. Longsword. There we go. I need to do more damage. Get him, Trask. Alright, now I can't move again. What's going on here? I'm gonna pause this real quick. I'm gonna try to, like, unplugged and plugged back in my keyboard. I don't know what's going on. No, it's like actually on the game. It happens like every time I do some sort of maybe if I like change my mapping, combat movement, and try to like do my arrows here. Actually, let me do move left. A. D. Okay. Select B. I'm gonna try that. Still can't walk. That is annoying. I'm not sure what's going on. Gameplay. Go back and just do default. Okay. Alright, Trask. Help me. My only hope. Like, what if my character, like, locks up? Like, I know what's about to happen here.
They must have retreated to the escape pods. We better head that way, too. Sith want Bastila alive, but once she's off the ship, there's nothing stopping them from blasting the Endar Spire into galactic dust.
Alright. Still.
Yes.
Level up. Skills. Level up our persuade. A lot of skills to work, or a lot of points to work with. We can level up all of our other stuff. Okay. Feats. A feat. Cancel. I mean, like, I don't understand what's going on with my champion. Maybe it'll, like, it'll fix itself once I get off of the Endar Spire.
Something behind here. Damn, another dark Jedi. I'll try to hold him off. You get to
see. I know a guy that looks like that with his goatee. And I still can't move. That's rough. What if I did to try to change it to where turn that on. Is my V-Sync? No. Keymapping. Cancel combat. Oh, it's the F button. Okay, I think that did it. Okay. So that's where he went. So I can go this way. Okay, I was about to like get really concerned, like why I can't
this
move.
This is Carthel Nassi on your personal communicator.
I think it just like gets locked in, like
the
kids,
combat support systems. Bastila's escape pod is away. You're the last surviving crew member on the Endar Spire. Now I can't wait for you much longer. You have to get to the escape pods, but be careful. There's a Sith patrol just down the corridor. Use your stealth skill to sneak past it.
So I can do.
I'll avoid what I can.
Just gonna sneak, don't mind me. I think if I get too close, they'll attack me. Like I'm right in front of them. I don't think their awareness is that high. It's actually a cool little interface. It's different. We're gonna leave it alone, actually. Oh, they know I'm here now. Critical strike. Are you gonna attack? There you go.
There's a whole squad of Sith troopers on the other side of that door. You need to find some way to thin their numbers. You could reprogram the damaged assault droid to help you, if you have enough repair parts. Or you could use computer spikes to slice into the terminal and use the Endar Spire's security systems against the Sith.
Hold up. We're gonna log out for a second. And we're gonna do the droid. And we're gonna do this. Cause I think I could experience points, but yeah. Just let the droid kill him for me. Nice. Works for me. I didn't even have to fight prototype fiber blade. Let's grab that. It does. Go ahead and grab that. Beer kit, credits. I think that's all we can grab here.
You've made it just in time. There's only one active escape pod left. Come on, we can hide out on the planet below.
I'm a soldier. I don't get escape pods with people I don't know. This isn't Uber.
Bastila's escape pod's already gone, so there's no reason for us to stick around here and get shot by the Sith. Come on, there'll be time for questions later.
You know what, Karth? I don't like how bossy you are. We're gonna have to talk about that, okay? You're too bossy. Use the escape pod. Wow, that was a close one. I look comfortable on that very flat bed. With my flat pillow. Where are my pajamas? Where are my pajamas?
Good to see you up instead of thrashing about in your sleep. You must have been having one hell of a nightmare. I was wondering if you were ever gonna wake up. I'm Karth, one of the Republic's soldiers from the Endar Spire. I was with you in the escape pod. Do you remember?
Stream, like a vision or something. Right, I'm Denzel Washington, by the way. How did we get here? Karth, the one on the communicator, I remember. Where am I? How did I get here?
I'm not surprised. You took a serious blow to the head. You're probably having all kinds of strange dreams. I wouldn't worry too much about it. You've been slipping in and out of consciousness for a couple of days now, so I imagine you're pretty confused about things. Try not to worry. We're safe. At least for the moment. We're in an abandoned apartment on the planet of Terrace. We banged up pretty bad when our escape pod crashed, but luckily I wasn't seriously hurt. I was able to drag you away from the crash site and all the confusion, and I stumbled into this abandoned apartment. By the time the Sith arrived on the scene, we were long gone.
Sounds really convenient, Karth. Do you have something to tell us?
Terrace is under Sith control. Their fleet is orbiting the planet, they've declared martial law, and they've imposed a planet-wide quarantine. But I've been in worse spots. I saw in your service records that you understand a remarkable number of alien languages. That's pretty rare in a raw recruit. But it should come in handy while we're stranded on a foreign world. There is no way the Republic will be able to get anyone through the Sith blockade to help us. If we're gonna find Bastila and get off this planet, we can't rely on anybody but ourselves.
Why is it so important to find Bastila? She's the one from the Endar Spire, right?
That smack to your head did more damage than I thought. Bastila's a Jedi. She was with the strike team that killed Darth Revan, Malak's Sith master. Bastila's the key to the whole Republic war effort. The Sith must have found out that she was on the Endar Spire and set an ambush for us in this system. I believe Bastila was on one of the escape pods that crashed down here on Terrace. For the sake of the Republic war effort, we have to try and find her.
How can one person, even a Jedi, be so important? If Bastila's a Jedi, she can look after herself. How do you even know Bastila's still alive? Forget it. How can one person, even a Jedi, be so important?
Bastila is no ordinary Jedi. She has a rare gift the Jedi call battle meditation. Bastila's power can influence entire armies. Through the Force, Bastila can inspire her allies with confidence and make her enemies lose their will to fight. Often that's all it takes to tip the balance in a battle. Of course, there are limits to what she can do, but from what I understand of her ability, it requires great concentration and focus to maintain her battle meditation. The attack on the Endar Spire happened so fast, she never had a chance to use her battle meditation. Like us, she barely got out alive.
So, how do you even know?
I don't, but Bastila's young, and she has a powerful command of the Force. We survived the crash landing, so I'm willing to bet that she may have too. Besides, what's the alternative? I mean, if she's dead, then no one can stop Malak and his Sith from wiping out the Republic, and I'd rather operate on the assumption that she survived.
Forget it.
Bastila is no ordinary Jedi. She has a rare gift the Jedi call...
Didn't you already tell me this?
Bastila's
you already told me this, Karth.
...can influence entire armies. Through the Force, Bastila can inspire her allies with confidence and make her enemies lose their will to fight. Often that's all it takes to tip the balance in a battle. Of course, there are limits to what she can do, but from what I understand, the attack on the Endar Spire happened so fast, she never... Bastila's gonna need our help. Many of Darth Malak's followers can use the dark side of the Force, and the Sith have already killed more than their share of Jedi in this war. Nobody will be looking for a couple of common soldiers like us. And if we're careful, we can move about the planet without attracting notice. A luxury Bastila won't have. She's gonna have half the Sith fleet looking for her. They know how important she is to the war effort. The whole planet is under quarantine. No ships can land or take off. So if Bastila's gonna escape Terrace, she's gonna need our help. And we'll probably need hers.
Yeah, definitely. What's in this for me, man? I get some spice. Get a new ship? What do you think?
While you were out, I did some scouting around. There are reports of a couple of escape pods crashing down into the Undercity.
It's probably a good place to start.
But the Undercity's a dangerous place. We don't want to go there unprepared, and it won't do Bastila any good if we go and get ourselves killed. I'll tell you whatever I can, though I don't know how much help it'll be.
What do you know about Malak and the Siths?
Everything I know about Malak is pretty much common knowledge. He escaped the trap that killed Darth Revan, his Sith master. With Revan's death, Malak became the new Dark Lord. It's obvious that Malak's a ruthless tyrant who'll crush anyone who stands in his way, just like Revan was. Experience has shown that the Sith won't stop until the Republic lies in ruins. Malak and his Sith don't respect anything except raw, brutal power. It's hard to imagine how someone who used to be a Jedi could become such a monster.
A Jedi? What do you mean?
Malak and Revan were once both part of the Jedi Order, but they were young and headstrong, and against the wishes of the Council, they went to battle the Mandalorians on the Outer Rim. Something happened out there. Something corrupted them and drew them over to the dark side. Or maybe there was something rotten inside them all along. I don't know. They formed an army of ex-Republic soldiers and Jedi who'd fallen to the dark side, with Revan at their head, until Revan was killed by Bastila's Jedi strike team. But even that didn't slow the Sith down. Malak just stepped in and assumed Revan's role. He took control of the Sith Armada and resumed the bloody conquest of the Outer Worlds.
You know what? I want to ask you
something
else.
I'll tell you whatever I can, though I don't know how much help it'll be. Taras was once a magnificent planet-wide metropolis of towering skyscrapers. That was a long time ago. The upper city, where the rich citizens live, is still pretty safe. If it wasn't for the Sith occupation and the planet-wide quarantine, it might not even be a bad place to live. But farther down, things have degenerated. The lower city is nothing but a slum overrun by swoop bike gangs waging a never-ending war for control. And the undercity is, well, it's even worse. The lowest level of Terrace is a wasteland overrun by rat ghouls, mindless diseased mutants that attack on sight. I've already entered all this info into your data patcher.
Well, that was very kind of you. You know what, Karth? I want to know more about you.
I understand why you want to know more about me. I kind of get the feeling we'll be spending a lot of time together over the next while. But this isn't really the best time for long introductions. We should stay focused on the task at hand. There'll be a time for that later.
No. I said, tell me now. Alright, so the sooner we start looking for Bastila, the sooner we find her. Let's go.
Good idea. We can use this abandoned apartment as a base. We can probably get some equipment and supplies here in the upper city. Just remember to keep a low profile. I've heard some grim stories about the Dark Jedi interrogation techniques. They say the Force can do terrible things to a mind. It can wipe away your memories and destroy your very identity. But I figure if we don't do anything stupid, we should be okay. I mean, after all, they're looking for Bastila, not a couple of grunts like us. All right, soldier, let's move out.
Who are you calling grunt? Rude. Check out this locker. Anything? Computer spike med pack. Very nice. You know what? I think for now we are going to stop the intro here. We're going to stop the series on this episode. Very excited to continue this. This is definitely one of my most favorite games of all time. And I'm just glad it's working. I'm really just glad I got it to work on this computer because it really is it's a quality game. So I hope you guys are looking forward to episode 2. For now, we'll see you guys next time.